chosen. What are you doing here?
The VIP lounge was closed. Broken pipe or something. I can't believe I have to wait down here with... everyone.
Sorry to hear about your lounge issue, but I meant, what are you doing here at the airport?
Oh, I've been on the road promoting Pro Wrestling Japan's upcoming Apex tournament. It's going to be the biggest one ever. For the first time, it's going to include WWE superstars who previously competed in Japan. And me, of course.
Interesting. You know, I'm on a bit of a comeback tour myself, and I'm a former WWE superstar who previously competed in Japan. Are there any spots left in the tournament?
You're still wrestling? I thought you walked here at the airport now. I was going to see if you could get that pipe fixed for me. You look like a plumber.
No, I'm wrestling, and I'd love to get in the tournament if you can pull some strings.
There is one spot left. I can get you in a qualifying match, if you do something for me first.
This better not be about the broken pipe.
I need you to say Chosen is the greatest wrestler in the world. Even better than the so-called Lock. Do that, and you will have the last spot in the Apex tournament.
I'm not lowering myself to that. At least, not right now. If I change my mind, I'll let you know.
Appearing in the tournament would have been good for you. You need all the publicity you can get right now. Seriously, you really fell off the map when you got fired from WWE. There were rumors you had become a toll booth operator. Have you looked into that? Maybe a better career choice than wrestling for you. Less chance of getting beaten up. Don't have to work with others.
I'm going to stick with wrestling. Thanks.
Did you fix the pipe? Is the VIP lounge open again?
No, Chosen, it's me. I don't work here, remember?
Oh, right. Did you change your mind about saying Chosen is the greatest wrestler in the world?
Yes, I'll do it.
Great. Whenever you're ready.
Chosen is the greatest wrestler in the world. He is better than I ever was or ever will be.
Say something else, and act like you mean it.
Every wrestler on the planet should retire immediately because no one will ever compare to Chosen. We good now?
Almost. Explain what would happen if you faced Chosen in the Apex tournament. You know, just for my own self-confidence.
Okay. If I'm unlucky enough to face Chosen, he will easily defeat me in mere seconds. Again, Chosen is the best. Okay, I'm done.
Great! My social account's been on fire lately. But this is going to put it over the top. My fans, the Chosen ones, are going to love hearing you say all that.
What do you mean?
Oh, that wasn't just for my self-confidence. I recorded what you said on my phone so I could post it. The entire world needs to hear you say Chosen is the greatest.
You're actually the worst.
Sorry, I already stopped recording. Can't take back what you said. Good luck in the qualifying match. Don't blow it.
The Apex tournament is finally here. How are you feeling?
A bit jet-lagged from the flight, but I'm sure once the bell rings, the adrenaline will take over and I'll be fine.
Why is this tournament so important to you?
This is a high-profile event where a successful showing would go a long way to rebuild my image. And of course, I wouldn't mind beating a few current WWE superstars in the process.
Got it. So this is the part where you explain the format of the tournament.
You really need to start doing your research. The tournament's participants are split into two groups. Each group's wrestlers face off in round-robin singles matches. Wins are worth 2 points, draws one, and losses, zero. The winners of the two groups face each other at the Japan Dome to determine the tournament champion.
And that's a big deal?
Yes. I've competed there a handful of times earlier in my career, but only in opening matches. The final of the Apex tournament will be the main event at the Dome. So yeah, I'd say that's a big deal.
Thank you.
I saw you won your first match too.
Obviously. But I'm not here to talk about the tournament. I have some feedback on the video you did for me.
You mean the video you recorded without my knowledge where you tricked me into saying all those lies about you?
Yes, that's the one. After listening back to it, your performance was lackluster and uninspiring. I didn't believe anything you were saying.
That's because I didn't believe it either. You're not better than me. And if I get the chance to face you, I'll prove that.
Sure. I mean, don't get me wrong. The video still put up big numbers. After the edit, of course.
I watched it, and the fart sound effects you added were a bit much. Can you delete it now?
And then you would pay me the lost ad revenue? Don't think so. Besides, I want it right for when I do a follow-up video after I win the tournament. It's all part of my plan to build my following even bigger and conquer the wrestling world.
That's my goal too, minus the lame social media content.
I've seen your feed. That is lame. Anyway, only one of us can get to the top. And Rock already had his chance. It's my time now.
We'll see.
You're off to a good start so far. It's going to be a tough few weeks to get to the end of this tournament and come out on top.
Any advice on how to survive?
You showed you could tough it out in the British Rules tournament. So, do more of that?
Thanks, I guess.
There is one way you could get some extra rest, but it would go against tradition. Typically, you participate in tag matches on tournament off nights, but you could skip them. So, you want to earn the respect of the Japanese fans and show them you have fighting spirit? Or tell PWJ and the fans to shove it and rest up.
My health and chances of winning the tournament are way more important than any tradition or making the fans happy. So I'm going to rest up and skip the tag matches.
I see where you're coming from, but be prepared for some backlash. Actually, I think I'm going to change hotels. Will be good for us to have some space.
If I'm understanding the tournament format correctly, we're nearing the end of the round robin portion, and after a draw against Ricochet, you're now 1 point behind Finn Balor, headed into your final group match, which happens to be against Balor.
That's right. So if I want to win the group to get to the finals and main event, the Japan Dome, I need to beat Finn. A loss or another draw, and I'm headed home empty-handed.
Well, hopefully you've at least picked up some cool souvenirs while you're here, so it wouldn't be completely empty-handed.
The only souvenir I care about is the Apex Tournament trophy. But to earn that, first I need to beat Finn, which will be no easy task. He's a top WWE superstar, so I'm sure he'll have some extra motivation to not be upstaged by me.
If you beat Finn, it's looking like Chosen is a lock. Sorry. It's looking like Chosen's going to win Group B, so you'd face him in the finals.
I'm not worried about Chosen. He's too concerned about his image and social media content to be a real threat. So if I get by Finn, the trophy's mine.
Thank you.
I'm working on my victory post for after I win the tournament final. Do you think 50 fire emojis is too much? Or will it really drive home the point that I'm on fire?
You ever hear the expression, don't count your chickens before they hatch?
No. Why would I not want to count my chickens? How else would I know how many I have? That is dumb.
Whatever. Point is, let's see how the match turns out before you start celebrating.
I already know how it's going to turn out. I went undefeated in the group stage while you had to win your last match just to barely clinch your spot in the finals. So, I have way more chickens than you.
You're really not getting that.
Also, your old friend Shawn Michaels sent me a DM that he'll be watching our match. Probably wants me to be his next Rock.
I don't think Shawn will be interested in signing you after I embarrass you in the ring.
Now, who's counting their chickens?
Thank you. Congratulations. So how does it feel to be the hottest thing in pro wrestling since Paul Heyman's undershirt?
First, it's great running into you, Justine. Second, I'm going to need a minute while I erase that image from my brain.
Heyman's words, not mine. Send him on my podcast. Any chance you'd like to come onto the show? Talk about everything you've been through since you left WWE?
Don't get me wrong. I'm a huge fan of your podcast. Tavish and I listen whenever we can. I'm just not sure I'm ready to start telling my story yet.
Oh, come on. Your run in the Apex tournament was incredible. And that's exactly what my listeners want to hear about. What do you say? I'll go easy on you.
No time like the present, I guess. Let's do it.
Great. Let's set up a time ASAP.
Hey, heard you on Justine's podcast. Loud and clear. Talking in code again about a platter of stale ribs you threw in the trash. Clearly up to your old tricks.
I have to be totally honest. I have no idea who you are.
Name's Chase. Had a stint at the PC recently? Or you might even know me as Ribby. Ring any bells?
Oh, for sure. You're that mascot guy who almost made it to WWE. How'd that all play out?
Oh, don't play dumb with me. You know exactly how it played out. I never got a contract offer because you told Shawn Michaels to stay away from the ribs in catering, which was clearly code to avoid me.
Wow. Listen, I'd love to stay and clear this nonsense up, but Cole Quinn called into my podcast appearance to talk smack, and now I've got to go give him a receipt.
Oh, I know. I was listening. I liked the part when he said you haven't changed one bit since your mocap meltdown.
We'll see about that. Good luck, Chase. I hope you get to the bottom of whatever deranged conspiracy theories you were talking about.
Oh, I doubt that very much. Thought you could just blow me off, huh? Not so fast.
It's not polite to show up without an invitation, Chase. Guess they don't teach that in deranged mascot school.
A good one. But I think it's about time you start taking me seriously.
You want serious? How about a match, tonight? And if I win, you leave me the heck alone.
You sure you don't want to catch your breath first? I'm not interested in Cole Quinn's leftovers.
Nope. You'll actually be doing me a favor. Two wins and one night is exactly the kind of buzz I need right now.
Very confident for a WWE washout. Okay, tough guy. If you've got so much gas left in the tank, why don't we make it a no DQ match?
Even better.
Thank you.
I have another big opportunity for you to generate some buzz in a different part of the world.
I'm gonna have to start paying you commission.
What are you thinking? 25%, 30, or maybe 20% plus a cut of all future royalties?
I was kidding.
Right. Me too. Anyway, I could get you on a show in Mexico teaming up with Hector Flores. WWE sending him to Lucha Magica for a special appearance, and the local promoters are looking for a hot commodity to team up with him.
I don't really cross paths with Hector much when I was in WWE, but I've heard he's a good guy. And if not, well, at least it'll be some good exposure. I'll do it.
All right. And the flight's on you, since, you know, I'm not getting paid for any of this.
Didn't know you were going to be here, too.
Same. I had enough of you after the Apex tournament. Thought I could be look-free for a while.
Don't call me that.
Okay. Look.
Gentlemen, you're going to have to learn to get along better, since you'll be teaming together tonight.
What? I thought you said Hector Flores was my partner.
Hector is your partner. Both of yours. It's a trios match. You know, Lucha Libre tradition.
You gotta stop doing stuff like this, Tavish.
I knew you'd throw a tantrum and not want to do it, which is why I didn't tell you. So I'll stop doing this stuff when you learn how to get outside of your comfort zone.
Are you two done yet? I don't want to do this either, but I'm not over here crying about it with a weird old wrestler who follows me around everywhere I go.
Okay, I see your point about him. But it's too late to change the match. Just put your issues aside and work together. You don't have to be best mates or anything. Deal?
It will be good content for my socials, I guess. So, I'll do it.
Fine. But just this one match. That's it. Hey, Hector. I was happy to be teaming with you down here. Until I found out we were also teaming with Chosen.
It will be fine.
I've known Chosen for a while. He can certainly rub people the wrong way, but he means well.
Maybe you're right. I'm willing to give this a shot if you are, I guess. But enough about Chosen. What have you been up to lately?
It's been an interesting time for me in WWE. I turned down the chance to join Los Lotharios, and they've been messing with me ever since.
Ha, faction trouble. I had my fair share of that in WWE too. You're better off on your own.
Yeah, in this case at least. Anyway, I'm happy to see you doing so well now. I had heard you were having a hard time after WWE. Someone said you got into a fight with Sami Zayn at a video game shoot?
Yeah, that happened. But it's all in my past, and like you said, things are going well now. So let's keep the positive momentum going and get the W tonight. Sound good?
Sounds good to me.
Yeah!
and sorry for getting you too involved in all this. That attack was my fault.
You didn't know that was going to happen. And now, this is our fight too. We need to get revenge.
But putting Chosen's mask on the line is taking things too far. I'm not a masked luchador, but I understand how important it is. Losing your mask can destroy your career. It could tear you apart both professionally and personally. So I've made the decision to call off the match.
If this is our only chance at revenge, then I'm willing to take the risk. We are doing that much.
What about your image? Your social media following? Your plan to be the best in the world? You could lose everything while we have nothing at stake.
It's what you would do, right?
I don't know.
Before you went to WWE, the answer would have been yes. I actually looked up to you back then.
You? Looked up to me?
Yes. You are so confident in everything you did. But then you failed in WWE. And not because management held you back. You headed yourself back because you lost that belief that you could succeed in any situation. You made excuses and blamed everyone instead of just doing the work. But I'm not going to make the same mistake.
I see. That's a lot to digest there.
Are you sure about this, Chosen? What if we lose?
I can overcome any setback. That's actually another lesson he taught me. I mean, look at how terrible things got for him. Yet, here he is. I mean, he threw everything away. Like, it got really, really bad. He was a plumber at the airport.
Okay, I think we get the point, but how about we just don't lose?
That works for me.
All right. Let's do this.
You've had some time to think about what Chosen said. Were you surprised that he looked up to you at one point?
Yeah, I was. I just thought he didn't look up to anyone. But it meant a lot hearing that, and why he thought my WWE run didn't work out. I'm not sure if I agree with everything he said, but it was interesting to get that perspective.
This mask versus hair thing is a huge deal in Mexico. It's actually called a lucha de apuesta, which means match with wager.
Someone finally did their research. Like you said, it's a tradition that goes back a long way in Mexico, so I take it very seriously. I might have had my differences with Chosen, but he's putting so much on the line by agreeing to this. So, I'm going to do everything I can to not only get payback against Legado de Lotharios, but also protect his mask and legacy. We owe him that.